So now that our environment is working, let's get some insights of what is happening inside my environment. So I'm going to check at incidents where we detect some anomalous things that are happening inside my environment. So here I have anomalous login. I'm going to have a quick check at it, and I'm going to see that inside the timeline, I see that there is some weird activities happening with this machine. So here I can see that this machine, actually, I'm having this amount of target for communication that we have, and I can see that in the timeline there was actually a set of strange login that is happening. So those logins are related to these users, and therefore alerts related to that, because we see this user being used on a set of workstations. So that's kind of sign of a very suspicious behavior that I can then take further to investigate what's happening. Another example here is traffic to known bad machine, somebody trying to play with Kerberos ticket, and here you can see, for instance, some traffic sent to Tor proxies. So you can do the investigate, and here you can see that this is this type of alert that has been raised. This is this entities, this IP address, and this machine that has seen this traffic happening. So the configuration of the intelligence is inside the analytics environment, where you have a set of predefined rules, the rules template, that you can define, and that are here basically using different criteria. So here, for instance, it's just a Microsoft source of information to create an incident out of Security Center. Here, Fusion is our engine that is going to actually merge the logs from very different source of information and then make sense out of it. And here you have the schedule query that actually is going to mix things coming from the DNS environment, the Cisco ASA, the Palo Alto as source of information. And you can see how the query looks like from the excerpts that you have here in the environment. So that's really where you customize your environment to add some more queries to really have what you want to see inside the alerts of your configuration. You can also go to the playbook. It's a very important aspect, which is, what do you do with those alerts? What is the automation that you do? So we use Logic App. Actually, you can create graphical workflow. Use the Logic App Designer to determine what's going to happen as a response to the security incident. So here, for instance, we see if there is an alert occurring in Azure Security Center, then I'm going to post a message into a Slack security channel. I'm going to send an email notification with this type, this subject, and to this email recipient. All of that without writing any line of code. So that's really one of the interesting aspect out of it. And there's a set of predefined templates. So here you see that Logic Apps comes with predefined rules that you can reuse automatically without having to create your own lines of code for it. That would be, for instance, integrating it with ServiceNow or any ticketing system to create a task for someone to evaluate and to take action on it. In the hunting activity, you can see also that you have active research, proactive research of vulnerability. So you have the hunting activity with a set of queries that are already defined by default. So here I can set, for instance, a query to check if any user has been added to the domain administrator account. And here I just run the query, and it hasn't been the case for the last couple of days. And you can see that I can be less granular and run all the queries at once. That's the power of Gusto query language and log analytics query. It's like, it's very fast, and you can see all the data. Here you can see, for instance, insight on what has happened in terms of failed logins to my Azure portal. So you see all the details of the information this user has been tried to access from this IP, from this geography, from this browser. And you can see that you have the full listing here, from instance, someone from France trying to use my credentials to log to this machine. So that's the kind of visibility that you have in the hunting section. It's really proactive search into the environment. Here I can see the bursting in the signing activity of my Azure subscription as well. All of this available in a couple of seconds. That's really important. Another important of it is you can create bookmarks, so then you can come back very quickly after that on look back on something that has happened, create an event, and then you see, okay, that's something of interest. I should come back to that at a later stage when I have more time. So that's an important aspect of it, save the results of your query. All the automation that we have, but if you have data scientists, they can also use their Jupyter notebooks and research on the security data and get new insights out of it. And you can also, of course, extend all this intelligence that we have present by default by using some things from the community that are present on GitHub. So there's a whole Azure Sentinel repository where you can get new ways to search for vulnerability. Here, for instance, I'm looking at a query that can look at the DNS names that are well known to be part of WannaCry botnet and malware. So that's a very important aspect. You can have different sections that enrich all the power of Azure Sentinel with new features live.